talking about the Project Watch. This is RP. Now, everybody I talk about Squid Games, like say, are the craziest thing ever touched Netflix. Complete nonsense. Jamaica is the ultimate Netflix series. Nothing can top that. We're now hearing, right, that one of the man them who took part in the operation in Haiti, right, you know, the one that ended up, right, taking the life of the Haitian president, was found in Jamaica. Yes, JCF Holland on him, you know. I wonder if you realize Wagwan, so. You know, just where the Uncle Sam come find fugitive at Jamaica. It looks like Jamaica is a dumping ground for wanted man for international fugitives. When time man from foreign, right, I scratched them head. Which one we can't hit now? Alright, wanted, so. Which one we can't go? Which one have enough wanted man? Ah, Jamaica, yes. Of all the country, he could have ended up in a. He find himself at Jamaica. Now, this case is very spooky. Obviously, from it first went down, right, we called it from day one. This was, right, an inside operation in terms of the people who set it up, right, Haitians them deal with this. Right. There is no way you can run in from the president, the residence of the president of Haiti, and you don't come up against, right, the mother of all shootouts. The man them want go in, take the man life, and want come back out. And all of a sudden, at them time, the police them ready to start work. You see, the actual individual where them catch a Jamaica, this man is an ex-Colombian soldier. As you know, most of the man them where them catch a Colombian, right? An ex-Colombian military. Now, this man, right, he did actually put out a statement to the Colombian media, right? Because, he obviously, he wanted, but, you know, I guess he figured they might get kept soon, so they want to put some things out there. So he did call a couple names and, you know, tell him family, say, look away, but and I really saw it go. Right. Basically, man said them get double-crossed. And I believe them. Of course, they get double-crossed. They were hired to do the work, right? But when it's time for the escape, part go on, the Haitians them double-crossed them. I'm going to give you some statements. Both from the man in Ketcha Jamaica, and the man in Ketcha Jamaica, he did call a man name, right, who the Haitians them catch, him did give a statement. Now show him, say, this is an inside job. One thing, if you look on the screen right now, as you can see, former military officer, right, so he was an officer, Mario Antonio Palacios, none of the two last name are the same name, them have, I don't know, right, but, right, one of the most wanted men by Haitian justice. That's laughable, right? This one. Right. Haitian justice. Well, I see him Haitian and take out the man anyway. Right. As you can see, don't at the bottom, he mentioned, say, be careful, this man is very dangerous. Very dangerous. Let me show you what the man said. The same red I want to see on the screen. Let me show you what I'm telling the Colombian media. These are his words, and I quote, I want to tell the truth. Tell the truth of everything that happened. I am a fugitive from justice here, right, in Haiti. Right, so I'm still a Haiti when I'm saying this. Because here there are no guarantees of anything. Here the police are all crooked. There is nothing here. This is no man's land. So I have been saved by my skin color. What am I talking about? Notice the rest of the Colombian them. With them wall and pan, but must say the Haitian them, the citizens, the wall and pan, no for the man them by themselves, you know. The reason why them could do it is because them look like, I guess you could say, a stereotypical Colombian. Right? When people, you know, you see narcos on them show, right? In Latin America, you know, Latino look. That's what people, like, most people think that's how every Colombian look. They're actually lots of black Colombians, right? So because in black, him look like him could be Asian. So when I time to take with himself, the man them will look like, you know, quote unquote typical Colombian. And the man them will look Latino. Right? The Asian them just wall up on them quick. We are there, so, right? This is a French speaking country, right? You speak Spanish, right? Where you come from? Oh, Colombia? Alright, come over here, so. But him could take off whatever uniform him have, or, well, you know, whatever garments him ever make him look like a soldier. right? Probably just change him clothes and can just walk around Haiti. So when everybody get one lamp on, right, because he's black, like the rest of the Haitians, then all man do is keep him more locked. Because obviously him speaks Spanish. So because him see the rest of the man get one lamp on, my youth just say, you know what, I just keep my mouth shut. And people are going to just run past me, and that people do, so he never get catch. Right, so him say it himself, he was saved by skin color. He goes on to state, I have been hiding in some places all day. I hardly sleep. I am very worried about my life. I'm not going to give myself up either. And if I have to jump into the sea, I throw myself. He said that to Semana magazine. In that same testimony, he assured that I don't know who killed him, matter what the president. I say this from the heart for my family, for my children. I don't know who killed him because when I got to that room, the Yepes commandos and Mr. Romero were already there. By the time I entered the room, the president was already dead. So he's admitting he was there. But he must have even know actually pulled the trigger. Obviously, enough of them go, and another one of them put rounds in him. Right? So he must have, when he reached the room, right, the president was already gone. Now the name I mentioned, Yepes, right, commandos. He might one of the man actually get catch. He said Yepes commandos like where that's a Tesha boy them. Our black man 87, so him say Yepes commandos. I'm going to show him with Yepes because they're more than Yepes and he's still alive. Well, last I heard, who knows what the Asian them doing. Right. But here Yepes say. That's his full name, Juan Carlos Yepes Clavijo. Right. Arrived in Haiti on June 6th. 1 month later, he's imprisoned and charged for what happened to the president. Now, here Yepes say. They told us that there was also a person who was there on the site, undercover. And that person warned us, he explained. I understand that it was of the same security as the person they were going to quote-unquote capture because he was inside the house. So if you have a person there, that makes the group relax a little more because we don't know what the residence is like. There was somebody inside the president's house who was supposed to be a part of the president's security detail who will work with them and them, right? Who confirmed the Colombian then. Remember when this first bust out and all kind of, you know, the usual, you know, wannabe Sherlock Holmes and tin foil hats on him head, where you see this Uncle Sam and this system try get him out because what it mean now is that they are bringing one new and then they have a new look of dopey where they put in their foot and that go up in their hand. And when I go up in it and then your brain go mash up. Man, all kind of foolishness. This is clearly just a typical inside. They want to get out the president, right? The same Haitians they want to get him out, right? And them hire a foreign man to come do it. Even before all this come up, they call it. It's a lie, me I tell. Right? You hear the man tell you, somebody inside, let them in. Where was the fight? You think you can run up in a president? The president as bad as Haiti maybe, you can't run up. As a matter of fact, the facts of Haiti so bad, make it even harder to get to the president because the president would have been under lock and key. Them youth would have been in a firefight for at least 4 or 5 hours before they get to him. And by the time the first 15-20 minutes, if, for me I talk about, that's foolishness. Let me take that back. 15-20 minutes, this is the president I talk about. Within the first 5 minutes of gunfire, reinforcement to the reach. The president, residence is under attack. Right. All units respond. Every Colombian in a job. The man then gets a stroll in, take out the president, and then I won't tell him I left now. All of a sudden, Haitian police start work. Right. Them start catch man, shoot man, some residents catch man. You think so the Colombian they may go upon this operation without having some kind of agreement for an escape? The man them tell them say, yo, brother, we not gonna go in, the body not gonna do nothing to him, do what not do, and then one time on the left, right, we're gonna tell the people them say, yo, on the escape into nearby bushes. So the Colombian, the man tell us make the group look more relaxed, man, because alright, we have smiled upon the inside, people, you know, this is an inside job, but they didn't get double crossed. They get double crossed. You see the same man them, right? They get out the president, get out the Colombian name, and now I try to look like hero. See there, we catch them, most wanted. See them line up there, here they are. mercenaries, come to kill the Polish president. Ooh, woe is me. And them said the man. Them same ones said the man. This cannot happen. Right? No external force could do this, right, without resistance. The same Yepes, right? Juan Carlos Yepes Clavio, they said this. Right? One of the soldiers involved in the assassination of the president, right, confessed to the investigators of the case that on the day of the crime, some Haitian policemen joined the group, which generated tranquility amongst them, because according, right, to them, they were not fully aware of the operation. So Haitian police link up with them, that made them feel more relaxed. Remember, they're going into a foreign country to carry out an operation. Right? No matter how much experience them have, that is extremely spooky. So when time them see Haitian police join them, right? You know, some of the men are even claiming to them never know so I kill them I go for killing them. Some of the men are claiming to them go to the academy to arrest them or arrest them. Now that part, I believe, you cannot be a Colombian national or left going to arrest them, man. Who the hell do you think you are? Right? I think, yeah, that part that unicorn meet, you can't be the Colombian national and the man hire you from Colombia to go Haiti to go arrest the president. That doesn't make any sense. Them get booked for the work, yes, right, but all the details weren't given to them, right. In my opinion, it goes something like, listen, you go learn yourself, you go meet up with them three squad here, we're not going to go into the yard, no worry, we're not getting the resistance, because we have our boy them on the inside, do what we do, and then when town are left, we don't care go there, so. In my opinion, it goes something like that. But when you get to the part where say, we don't care go there, so, the care never did it, so, a gunshot did it, so. Or some big stone or some stick, then get in the head. Right, then trick them on them. So now Jamaica is in a spooky situation because the Colombians want the soldier to be sent back to Colombia and the Haitians they want him to get sent back to Haiti. Because him they put Interpol red notice now. When the notice say, it come like a Jamaica alone. Come like a wanted man them alone, you see, you span this red notice list. When you realize, every other country from man Japan red notice with Interpol, then get hold on pan by the foreign country. I know then can't hold one at one. Man I'll start TikTok career. And I can't get catch. But from a new name. Right. And I'm look for him same way. And she said even the world, even Interpol and Jamaica seriously. Right. You know much foreign, we could talk about it. So JSAF help catch American fugitive, JSAF help catch Haitian fugitive, right? And nobody now catch Jamaica's fugitives in a freedom country. It's spooky. See, if Jamaica send him back to Colombia, it's going to be a major diplomatic row with Haiti. Haiti is our neighbor, right? Obviously, Haiti our family, right? We now have nothing in common with Colombia, except for the fact that maybe we both like football, right? So, in terms of who them rather, you know, upset, it more likely going to be Colombia. And remember, so we have the whole herbs going to trade, so Jamaica really want Haiti to our side, right? In terms of sharing certain intel and try mashing up the trade. If Haiti, I go say, give it, hand him over to we, make we deal with him. And Jamaica say, no, we are sending to Colombia. Next thing you hear, he say, alright, yesterday I'm holding a rifle, they were coming to the country, and every minute we catch man and lock up man phone here, they're pound the one. They pound the one, we don't even see nothing, we're blind. Right? We're not trying to stop nothing more, even though them barely try to stop it now, but right? You get what I'm saying. It's more like it's a Jamaica girl with Haiti than Colombia. If I was a betting man, that's what I would bet on. It would be a major diplomatic issue if Jamaica shrug off Haiti and say, oh, we are sending him to Colombia. Because if him drop a Colombia, you know, said Colombia now sending him to Haiti. The last thing Colombia wants is one of them ex-soldier, one of them ex-officer, right, figure in front of the Haitian police and the Haitian justice system, especially considering, say, it's clearly right, the Haitian them set up their own president. Anyway, it's spooky. Forget about squid games or unicorn games, whatever it want to be. Yeah. Jamaica. But the hottest series on Netflix. If you don't believe me, look out for the next episode. It keep getting spookier and spookier. Patreon squad, big up on yourself. PIA, you don't know, more life. Ultra squad, stay circling. Bless.